Okay, my friends, this is Roger once again from the only university on planet Earth that is factual. And this is a thing by Ben G. Thomas. The Earth 100,000 years ago, 100,000 subscribers special. Well, he's got 100,000 subscribers here now. And almost, 1.738 million hits on this. Now, this is the company line on the, Earth's history. And we now know that it's totally wrong. But listen to what he has to say. This is very, you see how many hits he's got here. And 100,000 subscribers. I give him 100% credit. These are all the sources. But these are all the sources of people that are in the mainstream. So he's taken off what he thinks is going to be reality. But listen to this now.
As a way to celebrate this milestone, we're going to be taking a look at what our planet was like 100,000 years ago, to see what the climate and geography was like, what animals were around, and which human species were living at this time. And yes, we may be a little bit late to this video, but don't worry, if we start working on the 200,000 special now, we should just about get it done in time, probably. We also have some very exciting announcements about the future of the channel at the end of the video, so make sure to stick around for that. So then, let's begin. The Earth 100,000 years ago. In the first section of this video, we're going to look at a few of the non-human animals that were around, or just dying off, about 100,000 years ago. For this part, I've selected an example of the most interesting megafauna from...
Alright, it goes on through basically the, what we've always been told, and into the Neanderthals and this and that. Now let's see if I can come out here somewhere and end it up. Alright, this is close enough.
Species instead. However, during the 1990s, archaeological excavations in Lower Saxony, Germany, uncovered 8 spears, since named the Schöningen spears, after the location of where they were found. The users of these spears are believed to have been Homo heidelbergensis, a human species that is thought to have gone extinct long before our 100,000 year mark. The attributing of the spears to Homo heidelbergensis means that this human species possessed the cognitive and intellectual capacity for anticipatory thinking, which would be needed to hunt. The importance here for...
You could see that this is 100%, these are just like monkeys turning from monkeys into humans. Basically, that's what they're talking about. And now we know that is complete nonsense. The truth of the matter is there was giants, and it was basically like what was written in the ancient text. There was gods, and there was giants. And it's all up in flux now because of what is been really understood now about giants, dragons, giant fish in the desert, giant dragons, and more than one, over 1,000 miles long in the desert. And these were on coins in the ancient days. The gods were here. And they were gods. They had godlike powers. I don't care what anybody says. That's exactly what was written, and that's exactly what I feel is true. And this was only 3,500 years ago or so. So we got a lot of catching up to do. This is right on the surface of the earth. This is not even buried. We need to look into reality now. Okay, my friends, I did a video on the Giant's Causeway about 5 years ago, and I am going to update it right now because some new things have come along. And this was just sent to me by a friend and said, will you look into this? And I said, absolutely, and here we go. Now, you see little columns, they call them. They say it's the eighth wonder of the world. And they think these hexagonal shaped columns, there's hundreds of thousands of them, on the coast of Ireland. Now, I will show you the anatomical, evidence. Now, Now, they think it was a pathway leading across to Scotland where Finn McCool wanted to go over there and fight with another giant. They say these are volcanic. Absolutely not. Now, I say this probably is Finn McCool. And this was a giant of absolutely unbelievable proportions. See, they say he built this so he could go across. Not the case whatsoever. Now, they'll show some other things in here. That's muscle tissue. And then, I believe, wait a second. Right at the top, whoops, let's go back to here. At the very top, you can see the abrupt transition. It's right up here. I don't know if you'll actually see it. See it right up there? That's the abrupt transition where the muscle fibers glue in to the tendon. There's another thing I want to show you here. At the very bottom, right there, you see? That is what the muscle striations look like. And you'll be seeing this, you see it? In a second. Now, this is some kind of a bone, some little... That's the tiniest little bit of a bone. There's that abrupt transition again, see it? And this thing was just absolutely enormous. Now, this was one piece, and that's another piece. I don't know what of what. I have no clue. But all of these are... That's biology up there. And it is just extraordinarily large. But Tyson has stuff that is of a similar size. Tyson and Scott Waz up there off the coast of Oregon. Now, the reason you can see all this is because it erodes away as the ocean has swept it around. This video is still up. I put this up about 5 years ago. It's on my old channel. It's not on this channel. It's on Mud Space Fossils. It's called Giant's Causeway is Actually a Giant. And then it's a no way, is there proof? And yes, there is. Now, let me just show you quickly the anatomical stuff. Well, you can see that's the muscle fibers. Let's just look at the tendons. All right, so this is what the tendons are. And they come in a big chunk of tendon. There's three big pieces. And then as you break the pieces down smaller, and you can see the smaller inside, smaller inside, smaller inside. You see, there's these hex fibers. And then they even get smaller, and they're still hex down to the tiniest little bits. And these creatures were just so enormous that when you're walking on this, you see all these... And you're thinking they're, you know, they thought they were volcanic, but they're not. They're all biological. See, this is electron microscopy. These are tiny little, they're looking way down into those little bundles. And these are the collagen fibers. You see them coming out of here? They put some color in there just so you can see, but that's what they are. Now, these creatures were just... so big, it's hard to believe, but it's true. You see this? I think this is Finnegal's Cave, they call it, or something like that. There's some more of these, and then there's that abrupt transition. Now, what that does is it glues these, and above this would have been muscle, which is eroded away. Muscle's weak. It's the red, weak stuff. This stuff is the tough stuff. It doesn't erode.